Hey guys, what's up? It's Missy Atlanta, and today I am coming to you guys to discuss living with chronic migraines. So I know a lot of you have seen, maybe in my empties review, or maybe me mention from time to time, that I have a lot of headaches, that I get really bad migraines, that I suffer from severe allergies and different things like that. So I just thought that I would hop on here really quick and briefly discuss living with chronic migraines, because it is definitely not just another headache. So for everyone who thinks that a migraine is just another headache, you have never had a migraine. So yes, I think I started having them really bad to the point of where I had to go to urgent care back in like 2012. That's as far back as I can actually remember. I've had several different tests done, different things, and over the last, I want to say year and a half or so, my migraines have taken another change. So I again have gone through another series of different tests and things of that sort. So I'm gonna go all the way back to kind of the beginning as far as I can remember and keep it brief. So back in 2012, from what I can remember going back that far, I at the time was an administrative assistant. So I was on the computer all day long for that, as well as I was on going to school full time online. So I was also, online all day with that. So of course, when I first started having the migraines, the first really bad one that I remember, I just was like, oh my God, like I just couldn't take it. I would like hold my head and just like scream like, ah! Like, and I thought people would think that I was going crazy, and eventually my mom was like, okay, let's go to urgent care. So we go to urgent care, and of course they didn't really say anything or do too much. They thought it was associated with my sinuses and different things like that. So that was that. So then I want to say like maybe a couple years or something go by, and I still continue to get headaches, which I'm thinking they're just, you know, headaches or whatever, but they continue to progress. So the next thing was I ended up going to the eye doctor, because at that time, I don't think back in 2012 I had glasses yet. So, but my vision and stuff was starting to get, you know, a little blurry, and I was having different problems and issues with that. So I went to the eye doctor, which is the first thing that a lot of people who have headaches or migraines very frequently do, is they go to the eye doctor to make sure that it isn't anything associated with the eyes or like the muscles and different things behind the eyes. Because when I was younger, I did have weak muscles in my eye. I have a lazy eye. And yeah, so that was eliminated. And you guys can see that I do wear glasses. I don't have them on now. But you guys do see me wear my glasses. Now we've eliminated that. So we go off into continuing to have these headaches and not knowing what in the world is going on. And then it would come around my menstrual cycle, I would get them even worse. So I know a lot of people have heard of menstrual migraines, and there is a such thing as menstrual migraines, and I get them every single month. But during that time, this time period now, I started having the headaches really, really bad. I would just be in so much pain to where I just felt like I was gonna pass out or something, because the pain was just that excruciating. So I called my mom one day. I was literally just barely able to move. No one else was home, anything. So yeah, she just kind of like watched me, evaluated me, and I got a lot of advice from my mom, because she worked in the medical field with doctors and different things like that. And yeah, so we go through that, and then I start going through all these different tests, feeling like a guinea pig. But let's rewind just a little bit. Okay, so I was rewind just a little bit before I started having all the tests and everything. I had ended up in the hospital for like a week. I have been sick for like 10 days. I was having my headaches, chest pains, all different types of things. And me being me, I ignore the situation. I'm like, oh, it's just whatever, blah, 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 blah. So they end up tricking me into going to urgent care. And then I ended up being, they were going to transport me by ambulance to the emergency room. I refused. My mom was pissed. She had to come pick me up from urgent care because I was having a really bad anxiety attack and I was refusing to get in the ambulance. So she came and she drove me over and they just they were waiting for me when I got there and I just went in. So I went in, they started running different tests and different things of that sort and whatever. And so it was like they ended up doing like some CTs and different things, and then all of a sudden here come all these people running into my room. They're hooking me up with oxygen and all this other different crazy stuff, and I'm like wondering what the hell is going on. I'm having trouble breathing. I'm just having all different types of stuff going on at that time. Well, I ended up having a spontaneous pneumothorax, which has nothing to do with my headaches, but that's how I ended up being admitted into the hospital and then to looking into different things, because they were thinking that I had like a catastrophic pneumothorax or something like that, which is associated when you're on your med. It's a long story. Look it up because I can't really explain that. I'm not a medical professional. I'm just going through my experience. So clearly a whole bunch of things have started to come up. So now I'm at the doctor's office like all the freaking time. I'm still having these headaches. Nobody knows why. So they start sending me to this specialist and that specialist. I start having MRIs and CAT scans and blood drawn and this and that and whatever. And nobody knows anything. Like, migraines are like one of the hardest things to determine. And sometimes it's really not a migraine that you're having, but they focus in on that because that's the main symptom that's going on. Long story short, my mom came in to the doctor with me because she was like, okay, this is it. This is enough. I'm sick of them doing all these different tests on you and nobody saying anything and blah, 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 blah. So she came in, she explained a bit of her medical history and my Nana's medical history. And so they made it urgent for me to go to see a female specialist as well. So I go see a female specialist every year. I don't see a regular doctor for those issues. But I ended up having a cyst, which was part of the migraines, but not completely everything, because after treatments, I did not end up having to have surgery, thank God. I prayed on it, a whole bunch of different stuff, and yeah. So I didn't end up having to have surgery. I did get placed on like a birth control pill, and they were able to shrink mine enough, and yeah. But that was causing some of my migraine issues, and at that point, they thought I was having like some endometriosis, but I was not. So it was like a bunch of misdiagnostics and a lot of different tests, and I just felt like a lab rat. And then I just like, okay, enough is enough. Over the last like year or so, now that I feel like I've taken so long to get to this part, my apologies. Over the last year or so, I had a really bad migraine. I can't remember when, it was sometime last year, that caused me to start having tremors. Everyone was wondering what was wrong with me. My hands and different things would just shake. I could barely do a lot. So, And me, I ignore things. I'm like, it's just my anxieties, this, that, and the other, blah, 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 or whatever. But it continues to go on. My family members and different things were noticing, and my coworkers were noticing, and everyone was beginning to get worried. So I'm like, okay, I will get it looked at or whatever. So that's when I started that I had a bunch of different more tests done. I can't even remember. Of course, they always start with the MRI, which I'm supposed to have annually. I think I did like some other different tests, and I had this one down, I think, and then I ended up going to see another neurologist who did it, and these are just abbreviations. I don't even know what half this stuff is. I ended up having an NCV, like my hands and my arms and different things like that. An EMG, also on like my hands and arms and everything or whatever, because when I went in to see the neurologist, I was having tremors at that time, so he could physically see it. I also had like a EEO and an EEG, a TCD, all these different whatever, and I'm supposed to have another test. I can't remember what it is, a C something. It's not a CAT scan or anything like that, but it's where they can go in and look further and deeper in at the arteries in my brain. So that will probably be my next test, when I can afford it, because insurance sucks. But yeah, so long story short, that is like the introduction to my migraines. And I don't know if I should make this a part two because I feel like it's so super long. But yeah, the point of this video was supposed to be living with migraines. So those are all the different tests and things that I've had to go through with having migraines. And it is definitely miserable. Living with chronic migraines is very miserable. Chronic migraines means that you have 15 plus migraines a month, lasting like 4+ hours. Like my longest migraines, I think, last 4 or 5 days for me, to the most part. And then you're still feeling really just tired and drained, and it's hard to get your energy back and different things of that sort. Me having severe allergies, it does not help at all, you guys, because I have, of course, regular headaches and different things associated with my migraines, my sinuses. Of course, like I said, I do have a monthly menstrual migraine. And I actually can tell the difference of all of the different headaches and migraines that I have, which is crazy, but I've been doing this for several years. I do have prescription medications that I take from the doctor. I try not to take them as much because they are very, very expensive. I do take Excedrin, sometimes ibuprofen, or both, not at the exact same time, but some days it's just like you're doing and taking everything to try and mitigate that pain. It is that horrible. I sometimes need to be, let's just go back to a couple days ago. So I had a really, really bad migraine a couple days ago. It started out, okay, I got off of work, I went, I picked up some groceries, had to pick up the mini. I could feel it coming on. So I try to hurry up and get home, try to take something that does not always work, you guys. And I did a video probably about 2 years ago on my migraine survival kit, and some of those things have probably changed, but for the most part they're the same. So I'll try to like link it. But yeah, so whenever I know that I have to be out for the day or whatever, I always have to be prepared that I may get a migraine because of the weather, the climate changes, just the temperature. I live in Las Vegas, of course, you guys, so when it's really hot in the summertime, I try to stay as cool as possible. I try to stay out of the heat. I try to do most things in the morning or in the evenings, just different little things like that. And I am sick a lot, so you guys will see me on vlogs and different things, like hanging out with the kids, the big baby, having events and different things like that. But what you guys don't see, that I don't show, is a lot of times towards the end of that, I am really, really sick. Like, you guys, like, I'm throwing up. I have been at the grocery store, felt it coming on, and just instantly just thrown up. It's like really embarrassing. But I really cannot help it. I try to make it to the bathroom, sometimes it doesn't work. I just don't know. It's like a really horrible, horrific experience, you guys. So I tried my aromatherapies, I've tried teas, mints, everything. I listen to you guys' suggestions that people have put in my videos, different things. Like, I try and have tried so many different natural remedies and different things of that sort. But yes, migraines are horrible. So you guys see me MIA some days, or if I don't have pre-recorded content that I can share with you guys while I am not feeling my best, then I might be MIA, and that's probably why. So that was the main reason for making this video. It's because it seems that I've been missing a lot more than usual, and I kind of just wanted to explain that, and also to say that migraine is not just another headache, you guys. And I think June is like National Migraine Awareness Month, so yeah. But I hope this video isn't super long, but I think it might be. But yeah, so thank you guys for watching. If you have any questions or anything or any comments, please leave them below. And I will see you guys and talk to you in my next video. Bye.